obviously we see the weather around us, and there are still people with the mental instability that believe in global warming, and they're just not getting it. With all the emails from Liar University in England and some of the other things, I gave something to Jim Villanucci. It was just a little clip from Joe Bastardi of theweatherchannel.com. The question I had for you, Republicans have not immersed themselves in information that is factually or truthfully correct so that they could argue it and defend it. Are you willing to do that for us so that when we send you there, you won't be a watered-down version of Republican or conservatism? You're going to be in there putting your finger in their chest and telling them what needs to happen.
Well, thank you, Jim, for the question. I intend to be a fighter for philosophy, and my philosophy is one of conservatism. So absolutely. Let me be more specific to answer your question. I, like most people, were rather appalled by the East Anglia University report, which came out several months ago, which I guess, Jim, at best is academic fraud, and at worst, a deliberate attempt to manipulate facts regarding global warming. And I don't mean to be flippant about this, but only God knows where our climate is going. And if you look at the recent snowfall in the East Coast, and certainly our winter, you know, you have the ebbs and flows of climate change. And that's just simply how things have worked for the millennia and for eons of time.
I've always thought the sun had a lot to do with it, too.
Yeah, the sun, the clouds. But it all points, however, to what I call a rule of common sense, not only when it comes to governing our lives, how we conduct our lives, but how we also legislate. And we need to use common sense when we talk about this this global warming issue. And we as conservatives, we as those of us who are talking about how we best move this country forward, need to have that rule of common sense. And as Jim says, we need to immerse ourselves in the facts, learn about the facts, and speak our mind accordingly.